What happens when you lock a piece of the ocean in a jar for over a year?
Will life survive or will it all fall apart?
That's what I tried to find out over a year ago when I collected algae, sand, rocks and water from the ocean. Now it has completed its first cycle of seasons in my window sill, and it doesn't look the same anymore. What started as a colorful ocean sample turned into something I didn't expect. Here's what happened in my ocean jar over the last 400 days. I don't live in a coastal area, so when I traveled to the beach in the 2023 summer, I decided to take back with me a jar containing an oceanic ecosystem. I did it as an experiment to know if these organisms can survive so far away from the place. At the beginning, there were different species of green and brown algae. I tried not to put animals on it because I was not sure how this was gonna turn out. But there were many small crustaceans swimming in the water, and there was nothing I could do against that. For the first month, nothing changed. The jar was doing great. It became a nice piece of decoration, full of color and with many small things moving inside. It was very entertaining for me to watch. Here I noticed a pink mass growing on the bottom, covering the sand. At first I thought it was some coralline algae because they usually have those pinkish colors, and they were very abundant in the pools where I took my sample from. But I was very wrong, and as you will see later, those pink organisms were about to take over the whole jar. After that first month, the brown algae started to lose color. The conditions inside the closed jar were not good enough for them. I wasn't worried about that. I knew some species would end up dying, as others would grow and establish. This is a natural process, it's called ecological succession, and it helps to create a balanced ecosystem that can survive in the long run. Those who are not strong enough end up disappearing. That's what happened to the brown algae, and that's what happened to the small animals that used to swim inside my jar. All we see happening in the jar are consequences of changes in different parameters. These organisms are no longer in the big ocean, so if there's someone producing or consuming too much oxygen, the whole ecosystem will suffer a big imbalance. Since I wanted to prevent the water evaporation, I kept the jar sealed for most of the time. Otherwise, the salt concentration would have risen too much and nothing could have survived. Temperature is another important variable. The ocean is so big it can buffer the changes in the temperature. But in a jar, the whole ecosystem is always at room temperature. Too hot during summer and freezing cold during winter. All those changes are the perfect combination for the jar to be under stressful circumstances for most of the time. But something major was about to happen. Because life got busy, I had to leave this experiment behind for a while. Little did I know that the jar had its own plans. So when I came back this summer, all my ecosystems were unrecognizable. Some of them were overgrown. The world's smallest ecosystem, about which one I made a video already, was completely dry. And the ocean jar was pink, very pink. What I thought was curling algae proved me wrong. And it took advantage of my absence to take over the whole jar. Now, it was growing everywhere, in the glass, covering the sand, in the green algae, and even floating on the surface of the water. Everything was covered in a thin layer of this pinkish stuff. I had to open the jar to take a sample, and a strong smell hit my nose. It smelled like sulfur, like rotten eggs. I used this microscope to identify the organism that was causing the color change. This is a very simple microscope, so the quality of the images is not that great, but there's valuable information I could take from it. This accumulation of circles are the cells. If we compare with algae with the same magnification, we can already see a big difference in size. On the other hand, this chain of circles are the bacteria in yogurt. That's enough for me to know that we are not looking at algae, we are looking at a bacterial bloom. To be more specific, a purple sulfur bacterial bloom. These are photosynthetic organisms, which follow a very different path to others of their kind. As you can tell by their name, they use sulfur as an electron donor to produce energy with the sunlight. And they thrive in the absence of oxygen. That's the reason why they started growing from the bottom, where less oxygen was present. And as the ecosystem ran out of oxygen, all the small arthropods that were swimming in the water perished.
I haven't seen them ever since. But that was the perfect conditions for the bacteria to spread to the whole jar, and that's the reason why it became so purple. Interestingly, what's happening in the jar is in a way the opposite of what happened in planet Earth 2 billion years ago during the Great Oxidation Event. Back then, the photosynthetic bacteria started to use chlorophyll and began releasing oxygen into the atmosphere, radically transforming the planet and allowing the evolution of organisms that depend on that gas, like me and you. Imagine a world before the first plants or animals, when bacteria like this might have covered vast parts of the Earth. This was the color our planet used to have in that distant past. Or at least that's what the purple Earth hypothesis suggests. So, can life from the ocean survive in a jar? The answer is yes, but not in the way you'd expect. What started as a colorful snapshot of marine life has transformed into a bacterial world where only the hardiest organisms can thrive. But bacteria are not the only organisms that are still alive inside the jar after 400 days. After opening it, there was gas exchange, and now the water is no longer purple. And I can see the green algae are still green. They are still producing chlorophyll. That means they are still alive. So if you are as fascinated as I am by the resilience of life, click here to see how freshwater snails adapted to a completely different environment. And thanks for watching.